Welcome back to your free training course for Windows 7. In this video, I will look at recovery options for BitLocker. BitLocker comes with a recovery key that allows you to recover your data in case of an emergency. But you can also set up a data recovery agent for BitLocker that makes the process a bit easier. The recovery key is created when you first configure BitLocker. For every hard disk you encrypt with BitLocker, you get a new recovery key. The same goes for BitLocker to go. Every USB drive you use BitLocker to go with will create a new recovery key. The recovery key allows you to access the data in a number of different situations. First, if you forget your password or PIN associated with BitLocker. If you use smart cards, the recovery key will help you access the data if you lose the smart card or it is damaged. If you are using the TPM, if you move the hard disk to a different computer, you will need the recovery key to access the hard disk. Finally, if a change happens to the system, such as the BIOS being upgraded or the boot sector changing, the computer will go into BitLocker recovery mode. The system will then ask for the recovery key in order to get the system working again. To recover BitLocker, you can also create a data recovery agent, or DRA. A DRA essentially allows another user to access the encrypted data. Using a DRA allows you to access the encrypted data if the password is forgotten or smart card lost or damaged. If you start using BitLocker in your organization, I would configure the DRA before you start configuring BitLocker. You want to ensure that the DRA is available to BitLocker before you start encrypting using BitLocker, otherwise when you go to use the DRA, you may find that it does not work. A DRA can be configured for BitLocker and BitLocker to go, so whichever solution you use, you should configure a DRA. You may be thinking, do I need a DRA if I have the recovery key? Well, the fact is you don't, because you can always use the recovery key to recover the data. But here is something to consider. Every implementation of BitLocker, every drive, every USB device, has its own recovery key. These can be stored in Active Directory to make it simpler, but imagine an enterprise with a decent number of computers. This can mean hundreds or even thousands of keys stored in Active Directory or via some other method. When you configure a DRA, the one DRA can be configured to have access to all your BitLocker implementations. From an administrative point of view, this is a lot easier than trying to manage thousands of recovery keys, even if you can store them in Active Directory. The process of creating a DRA is quite simple. You just need to configure group policy and add the certificate for the DRA to that group policy. The process requires you to configure an identifier for BitLocker. The identifier determines which organization BitLocker is being used in. This is a requirement by Microsoft for the DRA to work. The two locations for the group policy are listed here. The first is general BitLocker settings. These include the identifier and also general settings for BitLocker. The second is the DRA location. This is where you add the certificate that you are going to use with the DRA. I will now switch to my Windows Server 2008 R2 to demonstrate how to create a DRA for your company and some of the other recovery options available. To configure group policy settings, open Group Policy Management from the Start menu. The settings I'm about to show you are the same regardless of whether you configure them on a domain level like I'm going to do, or if you configure them on Windows 7. In this case, I will edit the default domain policy. In your company, you may want to create a new group policy to keep the settings separate from the rest of your settings. First, I will configure the general BitLocker settings that apply to BitLocker and BitLocker to go. These are found under Policies, Administrative Templates, Windows Components, and BitLocker Drive Encryption. The first setting, Store BitLocker Recovery Information in Active Directory Domain Services, allows BitLocker to store the recovery keys in Active Directory. By default, Windows 7 will automatically attempt to back up the recovery keys to Active Directory when it is used. Having said this, if the operation fails, BitLocker will go ahead and encrypt the drive anyway. When you enable the policy, you have the option, require BitLocker backup to Active Directory domain services. When this setting is configured, BitLocker will not operate unless Windows 7 can use Active Directory to backup the recovery key. The next option down allows you to store the recovery password and key packages, or just the recovery passwords. The recovery password in most cases should be all that you need. The key packages contain additional keys used to encrypt the hard disk. If the hard disk becomes corrupt, you may need these keys. The next group policy setting allows you to configure the default folder for the recovery passwords. When this group policy is enabled, you can configure a share folder that the recovery key will automatically be saved to. In some cases, this may be a better option than storing all the keys in Active Directory, especially if you have a lot of them. The next group policy setting allows you to decide if you will allow the user to save the recovery password and recovery key. The recovery password is a 48-digit key that is either saved to a USB key or printed to a printer. If you disable this, you should make sure that the keys are being backed up via another method, such as Active Directory. The 256-bit recovery key is saved to the USB device when you configure BitLocker to a hidden file. I would suggest leaving this option on. If you do not want your end users to have the recovery keys, you can switch this option off. However, I would once again recommend that you save the recovery keys somewhere. The next group policy setting allows you to configure the security BitLocker will use. If you want additional security, make sure the 256 option is configured. Remember that larger keys may have an impact on performance. The next group policy setting is really important if you configure a DRA. Provide the unique identifiers for your organization. List the identification fields that will be used with BitLocker. The first setting, BitLocker Identification Field, is used to identify your company. In this field, it is best to put your company name. The DRA, when configured, will only be able to access BitLocker devices that are configured to use this identification field. The next setting, Allowed BitLocker Identification Field, are the identification fields that are allowed to be used. This setting does not really do anything unless you configure another group policy setting called Deny Write Access to Removable Drives Not Protected by BitLocker. In simple terms, it works like this. You would enter in your company identification field and any other company fields of the device you want to use. For example, just say you do business with another company and wanted their BitLocker to go USB keys to work on your computers. What you would do is enter in your identification field and their identification field separated by commas. This would allow USB keys from both organizations to be used. You would then configure all other USB removable devices to be blocked. That's it for the general settings for BitLocker. If I exit out of here, you will notice that there are three folders under this folder. These contain settings for fixed devices, operating system drives, and removable drives. Each folder has similar settings. The removable device settings are covered in the last video. There is one setting that is included in each of these folders that is directly related to BitLocker recovery. If I open Removable Data Drive and select Configure how BitLocker protected removable drives can be recovered, this setting configures recovery options. When configured, the first option you have is to allow the data recovery agent. You don't have to configure this policy, as by default, data recovery agents are allowed. Personally, I would only configure this setting if I wanted to disable recovery agents or set additional options. The first option determines if a 48-digit recovery password will be allowed, required, or not allowed to be generated by the user. If you have complete faith in your data recovery agent, you could disable this. The next option is the same, except it applies to the 256-bit recovery agent. The next tick box determines if the recovery options will be available to the users in the BitLocker wizard. The next option, when ticked, will save the recovery information in Active Directory. You may be thinking, haven't we seen some of these options already? Having the options in two places means you could configure all BitLocker implementation to save the recovery keys in Active Directory, and then later on change it so that removable devices do not. This would mean fixed devices and operating system drives would save their keys to Active Directory because they inherited the settings from the above. Removable drives have been individually configured and thus will not override this setting. The next option, as the above option did, allows you to save the recovery passwords only or the additional key packages. The last tick box will not allow the user to use BitLocker until the recovery keys are saved in Active Directory. If this process were to fail, then BitLocker will not be able to operate. Now that I have configured the BitLocker to go settings, and most importantly, the BitLocker identifier, I can now configure a data recovery agent. To do this, I need to go to Policies, Windows Settings, Security Settings, and Public Key Policies. In here, I will find a folder called BitLocker Drive Encryption. To add a DRA, all I need to do is right-click this folder and select Add Data Recovery Agent. This will start the Add Recovery Agent wizard. Once past the welcome screen, I need to locate the certificate for the user that I want to use with the DRA. If it is stored in Active Directory, I can browse to it in Active Directory, otherwise I can browse to the folder. In this case, I will create a certificate for this user and use that certificate. To do this, open a command prompt. From the command prompt, run the command cipher with the R switch followed by the file name. Once I enter in a password for the certificate will be exported. Now if I browse to the file, I can import the certificate. I will get a message telling me that Windows cannot check if the certificate has been revoked. If you were using a certificate authority, you would not get this message. Now I can next my way to the end of the wizard and the certificate will be added. That's it. The DRA has been created and is ready to be used with BitLocker. In the next video, I will look at Direct Access. Direct Access is a new feature in Windows 7 that allows computers in the enterprise to automatically make a connection back to head office without the user having to do anything. This ensures that your end user's computers will always get their software updates and you can always centrally manage their computers. Thanks again for watching these always free training videos. For more free videos, please check out our website or YouTube channel.